Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my YouTube channel. So in this video we will be studying about the rapid sand filters. We will be solving two numericals. One numerical I have extracted from one standard book, and I am sure that numerical will cover the complete topic of rapid sand filter as a numerical part. And second question I have taken from the GATE previous year, which was asked in 2018 for 2 marks in set 1. So without any delay, let's get started. In between only, I will be telling you the formulas that will be used to solve the questions. So the question says that a rapid sand filter is to be provided in a water treatment plant for a population of 2,75,000, and average water demand is given as 200 LPCD liters per capita per day. So that means Q average is given as 200 liters per capita per day. One person requires 200 liters per day. The average demand is given, and average rate of filtration, that means velocity, is given as 15 meters per hour. We can convert this into meters per day by multiplying it by 24. So this is meters per day. The population, POP, population is given as 2,75,000. And the filtered water is allowed, 5% water is used in backwashing. Backwashing is a phenomena that is used only in rapid sand filter, because the voids of the rapid sand filter are quite large, and there is a very high possibility of them getting choked. So unlike in slow sand filters, we just cannot do the surface cleaning. Surface cleaning cannot be done here. Only surface cleaning cannot be done. We also need to do the backwashing. Suppose this is a filter, then backwashing will be a kind of upflow that will be provided to the filter from the downside. This will be backwashing. Some discharge is always kept for backwashing, that is QBW, and this takes some time. Suppose the complete rapid sand filtration process goes for 24 hours. Then suppose this might take 30 minutes. Generally in the questions it is always given as 30 minutes, 40 minutes, 50 minutes. Less than 1 hour is taken in the backwashing process. So this backwashing will also require some particular discharge. So we have to take this particular discharge also in account. We need to send the discharge that will be compensating this backwashing as well. So this needs to be taken into calculations. I will be telling you everything, just wait. And the period of backwashing is given as 30 minutes. This is the time duration of backwashing. Okay, and you have to determine the number of filters that will be required, and the dimensions of the filter are given as 10 by 4 meter square. Let us denote it by small a. So this will be 40 meter square is the area of one filter. You have to calculate the upflow velocity as well. Upflow velocity signifies the backwashing velocity. You have to calculate the head loss as well that will be needed to expand the bed to a height of 0.66 meters from 0.6 meters. Earlier, the depth of the bed or the height of the bed, we say, is 0.6 meters. And after expanding in the process of rapid sand filtration, the bed expands, the porosity changes. The expanded depth of the bed is 0.66 meters. You're also given with initial porosity, eta, as 0.5. And some other values like drag coefficient. Drag coefficient, why is this given? This is given because in the rapid sand filter, what happens, there is a turbulent flow. And whenever there is a turbulent flow, we calculate the settling velocity using the drag coefficient. That is why this drag coefficient is given in the question. Also, you are given with the specific gravity of solids as 2.5, and diameter of the particles of the medium is given as 0.6 millimeter. So this is quite a big data, and three things have been asked to you. One is the number of filters, another is the backwashing velocity, and another is the head loss, HL. So without any delay, let's get to the calculation. See, you have the area of one filter. If you get the total area of the filter, then you can divide the total area with the one area of filter. That will result into the number of filters. How can you get the total area? Simple, Q equals to area into velocity. Now this Q is not the same as this Q. Although the velocity is same as this 15 multiplied by 24, but you need to calculate the design value of the discharge. This is just the average discharge for one person. You need to calculate the design discharge by taking into account the backwashing as well. So how can you calculate that? First of all, you should know a basic formula that for design value, we always calculate the maximum daily discharge. Suppose average discharge is 100 meter cube per second and you design for this. But maximum discharge is 120 meter cube per second, but you design for this. So this value will not be considered because this is greater than your design. So we always design for a maximum daily discharge and not for average discharge. So how can you calculate maximum daily discharge from average? By multiplying the Q average with 1.8. So this will be 1.8 multiplied by 200. This is liters per day per capita for one person. So we must multiply it by the population to get it in liters per day. 2,75,000. So this is the maximum daily discharge in liters per day. We can convert this into meter cube per day by dividing it by 1000. So this will result in 99,000 meter cube per day. So this is the value of design discharge. But we have to calculate the effective discharge as well, because that effective discharge will take into account the backwashing. I hope you are clear with this particular point, what I am telling you. Let me tell you how. See, backwashing takes place for 30 minutes. That means for 23.5 hours, this is the value of discharge, 99,000 meter cube per day. But you should calculate the discharge for 24 hours. For 1 hour, the discharge will be 99,000 divided by 23.5. For 24 hours, it will be 99,000 divided by 23.5 multiplied by 24. This much water is needed for 23.5 hours. This is the value that is required. ये तो पानी आपको देना ही देना है. इस पानी में आपको कुछ extra पानी और डालना है. तो वो जो आधे घंटे का amount था वो आपने यहाँ पर consider कर लिया. लेकिन अब 5% loss भी हो रहा है आपका पानी का. ठीक है, तो उस 5% को आप कैसे cater करोगे? तो इसको आपको किससे divide करना पड़ेगा? 0.95 से. ये वैल्यू आपकी जो पानी की है ये 95% के लिए है, तो इसलिए 100% के लिए निकालने के लिए आपको इसको 0.95 से केटर करना पड़ेगा, डिवाइड करना पड़ेगा 100% निकालने के लिए. नाउ दिस विल गिव यू द वैल्यू ऑफ इफेक्टिव डिस्चार्ज एंड दिस विल कम आउट टू बी एज 1064 27.77 मीटर क्यूब पर डे. दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ Q effective. For this discharge you will be designing. Now this Q will be equal to area into velocity. Velocity is known to be 15 multiplied by 24. Divide this, you will get the area in terms of meter square. So when you will solve this, the area will come out to be, capital A will come out to be 295.63 meter square. To calculate the number of filters, you should divide A with small a. Capital A is 295.63, small a is 10 multiplied by 4. Length and width of the filter is given, one filter. So this will result in 7.39 filters. 7.39 filters is just an impossible number. So let us take 8, because if we take 7, then it will not work because we require more than 7 filters. So let us take 8 filters. In the question, it is not given to have a standby filter. One standby filter is always taken, by the way, because sometimes what happens, if any filter out of these 8 filters, if any filter gets choked or if any filter stops working, then we can use that standby filter as a substitute. Sometimes 2 standby filters are taken, sometimes 3, sometimes 1, or sometimes 0. Like in this question, there is no standby filter taken. Generally, when the value of filters goes on to 25 or to 40, then we take more standby filters. But since 8 filters is a very small number, we do not consider any standby filter, and there is no standby filter given in the question. So one part of the question has been solved. Now what else has been asked in the question? To calculate the upflow velocity. So how can you calculate the upflow velocity? Let me rub. See, in the rapid sand filters, we have some formulas like D by DE equals to 1 minus eta E divided by 1 minus eta. DEA is here, so eta E is on the other side. D is here, so eta is on the other side. D is unexpanded depth, DE is expanded depth. Eta E is the porosity of the expanded bed, eta is the porosity of the unexpanded bed. We know what is D, D is 0.6, DE is always greater than D definitely, because that is expanded, so expanded will have a greater depth. So 1 minus eta E is not known, eta E is to be calculated and eta is given as 0.5. So from this we can get eta E as, I have already calculated, 0.545. This is the value of the porosity of the expanded bed. Now you know one more formula, that eta E is equal to VBW divided by VS to the power 0.22. VBW is the backwashing velocity, VS is the settling velocity of the particles. How can we calculate the settling velocity of the particles in this particular case? अगर ये turbulent case ना होता तो हमारे पास एक बहुत standard formula है, उसको हम use करके calculate कर लेते हैं, but यहाँ पर हमारे पास turbulent flow होता है तो हम standard formula use नहीं कर सकते हैं इसमें. स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्मुला आप सबको पता है, जी जी माइनस वन डी स्क्वायर अपॉन 18 म्यू वाला फॉर्मुला होता है अंडर रूट. सो दैट इज यूज्ड टू कैलकुलेट द वीएस इन केस वेयर द फ्लो इज लेमिनार, बट हेयर द फ्लो इज कंसीडर्ड टर्बुलेंट. सो वी कैन कैलकुलेट वीएस यूजिंग अ फॉर्मुला 4/3 जी डी जी माइनस वन डिवाइडेड बाय सी डी अंडर रूट ऑफ दिस. जी इज एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी, डी इज द डायमीटर ऑफ द मीडियम पार्टिकल्स जिससे पूरा फिल्टर बना हुआ है. फिल्टर हमेशा कुछ पार्टिकल से बना होता है, सॉइल के पार्टिकल से. जी इज द स्पेसिफिक ग्रेविटी ऑफ द पार्टिकल्स, सी डी इज द ड्रैग कोएफिशिएंट. यू नो एवरी वैल्यू एज गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन, बस कीप ऑल द वैल्यूज इन स्टैंडर्ड यूनिट्स. डी वॉज गिवन एज 0.6 मिलीमीटर, सो कीप इट इन मीटर्स बाय मल्टीप्लाइंग इट बाय 10^-3. G is given as 2.5, so 2.5 minus 1 divided by CD. CD is known to be 5.02. Take the under root of the whole value. So you will get VS as, it is coming out to be 0.04842 meter per second. Put this value of VS in this equation. You know eta E, you know VS, you can calculate VBW. How can you calculate VBW? By taking logarithm on both the sides, either natural or to the base of 10. So from this formula, when you solve using a calculator, VBW will come out to be 3.041 meter per second. VBW, this is the upflow velocity or the backwashing velocity. The examiner can always confuse you by asking the upflow velocity and not directly the backwashing velocity, but they are not the same. Also the question is asking you to calculate the head loss. So again there is one simple formula for head loss. For head loss it is 1 minus eta g minus 1 and d. What is 1 minus 0.5 and 2.5 minus 1 and d is 0.6. So this will have the units as equal to that of the d. So this is coming out to be 0.45 meters. This was the last part that was asked in the question. I hope you are clear with this particular portion. Now there is one more question related to rapid sand filter, but since you have done the most extensive question of the whole portion, that question will sound very easy to you all, and that is asked in the 2018 GATE question. So let me read that out. A rapid sand filter comprising a number of filter beds is required to produce 99 mld of potable water. Backwashing loss is given as 5%, rate of filtration is given as 6 meter per hour, and length to width ratio is given as 1.35, and the width is given, and you are asked to calculate the total number of filters, and one standby or additional filter is also needed to be taken into account. So what is discharge? See, here the discharge is the design discharge only. Since you can read from the question that the filter is required to produce this much, it is not saying that this is the average consumption by one person. This will be the discharge that is needed to be produced by the filter. So we can convert this into meter cube per day as 99,000 meter cube per day by dividing by 1000. 99 mld ko 1000 se divide karke meter cube per day mein aa jayega. Velocity is given as 6 meter per hour. It is given in the question, you can read. Length to width ratio is given as 1.35 and width is given as 5.2. So from this you can calculate the length, as simple as that. Water loss, WL is given as 5% due to backwashing, and standby is I told you one additional filter has to be added to the filters that is coming from your formulas. So first of all, you need to calculate the effective discharge. So Q dash is 99,000 divided by 0.95. This discharge is the discharge that is equivalent to no loss. जो आपको 99,000 मीटर क्यूब पर डे चाहिए ही चाहिए, बट अगर लॉस हो रहा है तो ये आपका किसके इक्विवेलेंट हो जाएगा, 95% के इक्विवेलेंट हो जाएगा। तो इसलिए इसको 0.95 से डिवाइड करके आपने निकाला 104,210.526 मीटर क्यूब पर डे। यू हैव द लेंथ, लेंथ कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड फ्रॉम दिस फॉर्मूला, सो इट इज कमिंग आउट टू बी 7.02, बी इज 5.2 गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन। So Q dash equals to area into velocity. You have velocity. From this you can calculate area, and area is coming out to be 723.684 meter square. Number of filters can be calculated by capital A by small a, 723.684 divided by 7.02 into 5.2. So number of filters is coming out to be 19.824. You can round it off to 20. Everything is same as in the previous question, but this is a smaller version of that question, and very limited things have been asked in this question. So total will be 20 plus 1, since you have to take one for standby. So 21 filter beds you require. Sorry, filters you require, not the beds. So this is given in option number C, and this is your final answer. I hope this question is completely clear to you all. So this is all for rapid sand filters, and you can check out the other videos of environmental engineering lecture series, and I have made numerous number of videos, and you can check them out, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more updates on many more subjects. Thank you everyone.